battery. So if we connect this, then we hit our on-off switch. It turns on, like that. Next step is to install our finished circuit inside of our race car. We are gonna put it in here. So that way it can go zoom. The first step is making sure our motor is attached in the front with enough space for our propeller. Now that that's in place, we need to make sure our battery pack is nice and secure in the back. All that's left is to attach the switch. Ooh! Now we have our circuit installed. I put the on-off switch in the back so it's easy to turn on and off. We've got the battery, all the cables, and the motor up front. The last thing that we need to do is to put on our propeller. And done!
Let's go for a test drive.
You heard the penguin. Let's go!
Go, race car, go! This boat is spectacular.
So I sent Peck a bunch of random stuff, and he said he could make a robot with it.
So Dean's a robot?
Yeah.
Make sure to test him out. Have fun!
Okay.
Do you see a button, Ryan?
I see a button over here. It's a lever. Let's see what it does.
We should name him. He's so cute.
Yeah.
It's like a pet. Robo pet. What's his name?
Maybe Bearplane, because it's like an airplane, but then it goes backwards.
Airplane, okay. Oh, so cute. Hi, Bearplane. Okay. Ooh. Okay. So, okay, my turn. So this one, I found the switch right here. Let's see what if it works. The last one. Let's see. Can you turn it on? Woo!
Whoa! It's spinning!
Whoa! It's coming toward us! Oh. Hello!
Don't forget that it can also draw two! Yay colors!
Thank you for watching our Making Robots with Everyday Household Objects video. Bye! Remember, always stay happy and rise up. Bye!
Let's turn it on.
Hey guys, today we're doing the baking soda and vinegar science experiment. But first, pretend this is a volcano. First, you're gonna need some baking soda. So we have to put it into the funnel inside your water bottle. Okay, next you're gonna put food coloring into your vinegar, and I choose red.